And so it is with visions, with dreams. There must be an understanding that obstacles may come. But still, that Holy Spirit that dwells on the inside of you shall urge you and embody you and to drive you to keep on pushing, to keep on moving, to keep on doing what God has called you to do. Many times when problems arise, we stop doing what God has called us to do and focus on our problem instead of focusing on our God. We must always remember that every man and every woman who submits their life to serving God will progress in due time. They may go through some disappointments, but yet and still God is still in control. But that man and that woman who overcomes it, it must be in their heart that they purpose to do something great for God. It must be that God is manifesting their dreams and their vision on the inside, filling them up like he did with Caleb. And Caleb boldly said, "Give me mountains." And when he said it with an attitude. So when we desire things from God, not saying that we have to be disrespectful to God, but we desire those things, we have to be boldly, step boldly, and ask God to manifest those dreams and desires that we are asking or hoping or wanting for.
All right, now.
The Word of God is very clear about its concept of us reaching for our dreams and our desires.
Yeah.
A relationship with God carries over into all other aspects of one's life. Do you believe?
Yes.
Do you believe that your faith has to be strong if you believe that your dream is going to come to fruition?
Yeah.
Or do you say that you can speak something and it's going to happen just because you spoke it? Or do you speak something believing that our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ is going to allow it to come to pass?
Hallelujah.
Sometimes God can hold back dreams from being fulfilled until a time in the future that the strength is bolstered, or until that pride is eliminated, or until our faith has truly grown. And God sees our faith, and then he said, "Hey, well done, that good and faithful servant. I'm going to allow you to receive that dream and vision that you're desiring." How many of y'all want to receive your dreams today?
Yes.
But you have to be steadfast on them. How many of y'all want to receive that? Do you really want to receive that dream?
Yes.
Many times in life, we don't want to go through the pain and the anguish and the heartache of going through our dreams. We want everything to happen right now. We want to be like that microwave generation. It got to happen in an instant. We don't want to get in the fire as they used to have to do with the wooden stoves. Put the wood in the fire, put a little gas and light the fire and allow it to burn. We don't want to go through that burning process. We don't want to go through no stripes, no pains, no inclinations or anything happening. We wanted everything to go plain and simple. Everything to be straight and narrow. Everything that don't have no hiccups at all. We want everything to be smooth. But God said everything's not going to be smooth for a Christian. We're going to go through some heartaches and pain. We're going to lose some loved ones. We're going to lose some things. We're going to endure because we have God on our side. Still, David's whole desire was still to build this temple for the Lord. Life will never get any happier by giving up great ambitions or giving up on your ideas that you cannot fulfill. A dream is yet a dream. May happen, may not happen, but still push the course. Joel in the Old Testament prophesied that one of the marks of the Spirit would be that you would dream. Would dream and have visions, signs and wonders being seen. Not only did David receive a personal blessing, but those who came after him were blessed from his vision, from his dream. Solomon would have never built the temple if David didn't have the dream, if David didn't have the vision, if David didn't engrave that into Solomon's spirit. Solomon accomplished what David did. Solomon used all the materials that David had collected over the years to build that temple. The dream of the father became the task of the son. Our Father in heaven has a dream for us as his sons and daughters to accomplish the spreading of the word here on this earth. Men do well to cherish a great purpose in their hearts, but the purpose that God gave each and every one of us is to love our fellow brothers and sisters, to keep God's commandments, and to do what God has called us to do. Every trial brings out some failure, but with God, all things are possible. Every success is built on a foundation of a baffled disappointment. Because someone dreams, someone else will catch the vision. Seek out the great purposes of that vision. Sometimes that vision will strive or start a revival. Sometimes that vision will make you go seek holiness. Sometimes that vision will make you even spend more time with God. Sometimes that vision and dream will strive you to make a difference in this lifetime. Sometimes that dream and vision will seek you to be encouraged and to encourage others. Although the full scope of our dreams never may be accomplished during our tenure of this life, but don't give up hope. The dream you have may make this world a better place for you and for me. Disappointment and sacrifice are the price tags of success of your dreams. Involving ourselves with disappointment and sacrifice causes us to enroll with the great group of pioneers that led the way for us today. Those martyrs, those apostles, those great leaders of the Bible, and even our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ led the way for us today. How does God look at an unfilled dream? He looks at it and he looks at your heart. God takes the will for deed and he rewards honest efforts of achievement. He rewards the heart. Because David did well with what was in his heart and what was with his dream, God still blessed him evermore. God manifested in him to be a ruler over kingdoms, to be a warrior, to be something great, just as God is manifesting in all of us to be great. Amen. The man who strives to be pure is a man that God is manifesting in 2017. A man who seeks to win is a man in 2017 that God is looking for. A man who seeks to be Christ-like, man or woman, who seeks to be Christ-like, is what God is looking for in 2017. God is manifesting in 2017 a new year, a new day, and a new you. But you have to allow God to manifest your dreams in 2017. Although he may never allow you to reach that dream that you may be dreaming, keep on pushing for him. Keep on seeking the knowledge through our basic instructions before we leave this earth. Amen. And allow them basic instructions to rest and abide in your heart. Allow those things to just seep in your mind and dwell in your heart. We must work at having faith in our God. We must work at having faith in our dreams and allowing God to manifest them, not in our time, but in his time. We may not live to see our dreams come to fruition, but the dream and vision was laid and manifested before the Lord, our God. Amen. That dream, you dream, keep dreaming. So let's let 2017 be our year. That year that we allow God to manifest our dreams, our visions, and our desires. Let us be like David. And no matter what may come our way, no matter struggle, no matter pain, no heartache, whatever we may experience, let us just keep pushing towards our dream. Yeah. Let us allow God to manifest our dreams in 2017. Amen. Let us pray. Oh, gracious and loving Father, we thank you, O God, for this day and all that has been said and done. Oh God, we ask that you just honor our requests and our heart desires and our dreams that we dream to be more like you, oh God. Oh God, continue to bless us, oh God, and use us in a mighty way in 2017. Allow us to reach the lost, oh God. Allow us to get our lives in order, oh God. Allow us to manifest those things that we desire in this life. Whether we receive it or not, let us just keep pushing towards you and all of us. Oh God, we thank you right now, oh God, for allowing us to just cross over and just experience this glorious day in January 2017. God, we ask that you just continue to abide in our hearts, oh God. Abide in our minds, oh God, and abide in our spirits.